Assertivo. Awesome. Hi everyone, this is Chicho. We're on February 19th, 2019, and we're doing another cooking live stream. Okay, it's been a couple of months, or at least a month, that we've done one, and it's a good time to do. It's winter, raining, nice time to spend the kitchen. And what we're gonna do today is cook basically a Persian dish, which involves chicken, rice, and usually sour cherries, but I end up using just straight up cherries. Okay, so we're gonna make a cherry rice chicken dish, traditional style, to a certain degree traditional style. I've added my own little twist. This is a family recipe that I've sort of played around with, and making this sort of, the second time really that I've tried it in this format. I modified a little bit as well in the last time that I did it. I really like what we ended up doing. And there's gonna be a little bit of downtime because we're gonna cook the chicken here, make the rice, and then we're gonna use the oven as well. And when the dish is in the oven, we're gonna have some downtime, so we might make a couple of other dishes. Aside from that, open discussion. Welcome to the live stream if you're watching this on another platform. I hope you enjoyed the cook. Okay. Aside from that, it usually takes a few minutes for people to drop by, so we're just gonna chill for, 10 minutes or so, and just wait people to get onto the stream on Twitch. Okay, and then we'll go ahead and start doing our thing, a little bit of prep. We've got very little prep actually to do for this. I did the chicken prep yesterday, because I usually like to take care of chicken when I buy it, trim the fat off and stuff like this. That way, when I'm doing the cook, I'm not messing around with the chicken, because when I play around with the chicken, I wipe everything down as well. And what are we in? We're a couple of minutes in. That was a quick little intro. And this is a third live stream we're doing for this set of streams. Yesterday, we did a discussion on the great generational transfer of wealth, sort of related to economics, politics, personal finance, investing, stuff like this, and future job growth. And we looked at some data. It was a nice stream. Really enjoyed it. And the day before, we did a math live stream where basically I make myself available for a couple of hours, once a week, two, three, four times a month, for a couple of hours for anyone that has math related questions, specifically for high school mathematics. I make myself available to help them out, if they need some help to explain a concept, to help them work their way through a problem, or teach them a certain topic in high school mathematics. And those are fun. This time we didn't do too much mathematics. This time we talked about life and health and meditation and fasting, and we just went on tangents everywhere for a couple of hours. So it was a great little open discussion. Should I show you? Should I start showing you guys some of the stuff we're doing? Start a cooking stream. Oh yeah, let me show you what we got as far as ingredients goes. We're gonna use up a little potatoes. Hey King, how you doing? Casey, how's life? We got some potatoes. We got one lemon. Okay, that we're gonna use a little spices wise, we're gonna use a little salt. We're gonna use basil, a little bit of basil. We're gonna use turmeric. We're gonna use mint and rosemary. That's basically it, as far as spices goes. Okay. As far as the lay of the land, same as before. I got two other cameras set up here. Right? We got this camera here is where we're gonna do a little bit of prep on this side, right? And then we're gonna free up the stovetop and cook the rice here. Okay, so this, we're just gonna chop up some onions, get them cooking with the chicken, and then we're gonna take this cutting board away, and on the lower cutting board, we're gonna cut up the potatoes to lay down on the bottom of the tray before we put the stuff together and put it in the oven. Okay. And then we have this camera here. Where's my little clicker? This camera here, where we're going to be cooking up the chicken. And I, in general, I don't, what do you call that? I had to kick this camera up a little bit, just for those of you who are interested in it, because I know some people have constantly been asking me how I put this stuff together and stuff. So I'm sharing as much as I can, because more of this, the better. So the usually these two cameras are on the same height, but this one I have to prop up a little bit because this pot is bigger than the other ones. Usually I try to cook the chicken and stuff like this in a taller pot so we don't get too much splatter and give room for the steam to go through the food and you can mix it easily without getting splatters everywhere. Okay. And usually I when I do this type, this type of cook, I wear my apron. Okay. And I might wear it. And this is an apron that I made in high school in grade 8. Okay. But what I've done with this shirt is I've done some cooks with this shirt, so I got some grease spots on here. So I'm just gonna wear this because it's not gonna be too messy. If I'm doing anything messy in regards to like dealing with meat, chicken, frying things up, and stuff like that, where there's gonna be a lot of splatter, then I definitely do wear the apron. Okay, when we're doing something like this, not necessarily, not that much. So we're about 6 minutes in. There's already a few people here. We got our one mod here at least. We got Casey here, and he takes care of business quite well. Thank you very much, Casey. I hope you enjoy the cook today. It's good food. I changed up the recipe from previous stuff, what I was told from the generations, my mom and grandma, how to do it, and I like my additions to it. There gives it a little bit more flavor. The dish is usually a little bit simpler, the rice dish, but I layer it in with the onions and stuff. Twice cooked pork. Welcome back. Welcome back. We should be cooking some pork. Sneaky, how are you doing? We're gonna start doing the cook. Okay, guys, or gang. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna turn on the cameras, okay, because we're gonna do some work here, chop chop stuff up, and we're gonna get the pot heated here, put the olive oil in, and first thing I'm gonna do is chop up some onions. So I'm gonna grab, turn on both cameras. Okay, now what I do, this one with the pot, what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna put it on low for now. And I'm gonna put it on low. This is a double element here, I'm gonna show you. Okay. There's a center element and a bigger element. I'm not gonna use the bigger one right now. I'm just gonna heat up the center one right now, the smaller one. It doesn't cover the whole pot at the bottom of it. Usually you wanna cover the whole pot, but this is a fairly good pot. It's got a nice solid base and it spreads out the heat. And I'm putting it on low because I just want the olive oil to get heated up, and by the time it's nice and heated up, we can throw the onions in, and hopefully we'll hear a little bit of sizzle and just let it cook. And then we're gonna add spices and add the chicken, okay? The other reason is I got my cutting board here and it's going all the way to the edge here, so I'm not gonna use the double element part on this. So let's put this on low, throw in some olive oil. Not much, just enough to cover the pot. The bottom of the pan, right, when it's heated up. Now let's bring out our onions. I'm gonna use a couple of big guys. Okay. Now, let's put that one over there for now. Let's cut this up. Okay, we've got a nice little sharp knife. Nice medium sharp knife. Oh, hold on, before I do this, let me give my hands a wash. I already gave them a wash earlier, but I was sort of in a holding pattern here for the last 10 minutes or so, just making sure everything's set up. So poured myself a drink. I got tea. Regular, I got my tea going. Hey man, can't stay, just popping by. What are we cooking? We're cooking cherry rice chicken dishes, a Persian dish that I've sort of modified a little bit to suit my taste. And then we're gonna make tahdik in a pan. The way we're gonna put potatoes as well as bread on the bottom of the pan, layer the put some bread in or potatoes. I got two of them going, so we're gonna do both bread and potatoes. Put the chicken on top of that, put some of the onions that we're gonna cut up, like cooked in the chicken, on top of that, and then on top of that, layer or put in the layer of a rice with cherries, okay. And then I'm gonna slip that into the oven and cook it. I'm gonna cook it a little higher. Usually, you let it cook for about an hour and a half or so. And well, it depends on the heat, but I'm gonna kick up the heat a little bit and try to get the bottom crispy, because that's what you want in the bottom of it. And what happens is the cherry sweetness sinks into the chicken and the bread and the rice. It's delicious. Hello, Chicho and Chad. Hope we are all doing good, doing phenomenal, Sneaky. We got a couple of sneakies here. Cool. Just black tea today? No, not just black tea. This is actually black ginger and black tea. I got my teapot going here. Oop, let me show you this. My teapot going here, you know, the way I in the video that we put together. So I got Persian black tea and fresh ginger. I cut up some ginger, you know, a chunk here, and I chopped it up, threw it in there. And we're doing a cook. I got lemon liqueur going. Okay. With a nice little lemon piece in there that we'll probably munch on during the cook. Usually, outside of my liquor cabinet, I have a smaller jar of lemon liqueur in the sort of the area in the kitchen where we have everything, where we use up, you know, we got salt and we got the honey and pepper and this and that, just random stuff that we use on a regular basis. I have, you know, the jar of liqueur sitting in a little dish because it does get sticky, so I just have it sitting there. And every now and then when I'm doing cooks, I pour myself a little liqueur, usually lemon, soon to be other things. People have recommended a few different types of liqueurs to make. Damn, now I have to stay. Sounds crazy. It's delicious. It's really good. What's up, Chicho? Tried to blueberry liqueur last night. Strong, but good. Yeah, blueberry ends up being stronger. Give it time, it'll chill down a little bit like the cherry. Nice. They make fantastic night. They make amazing nightcaps. Okay. So let's chop this up. Get this sizzling that way. Because we are gonna have downtime in this while the stuff is cooking up in the oven. So I usually just throw things in the compost. Try to compost as much of the food as we can, really. And we put it in yogurt containers. That way, it's not piling up. And then, what do you call it? Just take it in outside. We have a little compost thing, that machine. You know, they come around once every 2 weeks and take all the compost away. And any meats and stuff, and they also take meats. Any meats and stuff, I'll show you. We basically put them in the freezer, and if it's gonna be a while, if the freezer's packing up, you know, we can sometimes throw it down in the garbage, but usually in the compost, we put it in. No sneakies today, yeah. Will Chicho start crying because of the end? No, not these ones. These ones don't make me cry. Yeah, they didn't. The last batch didn't anyway. Maybe. It's good though. It's getting tears in the eyes is awesome. It feels good. It cleans, and it's a great sensation. I was watching your stream of yesterday. Only 21 minutes so far. Did you like it, Sneaky? It was a good stream yesterday. I think it went quite well. I sort of wish I ended up recording it with a camera. camcorder with a lapel mic, so I could bring it into the editor and overlay it with videos and stuff, but it's difficult. My computer isn't strong enough to bring in the full-on live streams, the 2-hour-plus streams in there. And I start giving problems. My computer gives hiccups. So, in general, I'm not recording the really long streams. Or in general, I'm recording them if I want to edit them. Sometimes I don't know how the stream is going to turn out, right? I think it's the smaller onions that make you cry. Is it? Cool. The bigger ones are awesome. You can chop up and get so much. You don't have to peel as much. Had onion tears earlier. I got through the chopping fine, but I hung around the board to prepare some garlic, and it got you out. I heard, what was the trick that people use? In, I know here, because I don't as much. We used to eat a lot of raw onions when we were kids. I don't as much anymore. Right? But one thing we do to take the sting out of the onions is soak them in. Oh, these are actually stinging. I can feel them a little bit. We soak them in water. So you take a bowl of water and you chop up onions if you're going to eat them raw and stuff like this. You chop them up, right, in, like slices, and you throw them into a bowl of water, and you can put it in the fridge and just eat it, or just put them in a couple hours before you're going to start eating them. It takes the sting out of them. But in general, you don't want to leave cut onions in the fridge because they suck in, from what I understand, they suck in smells and toxins. So if you're going to use onions, don't chop up onions and just put them in the fridge by themselves, right? If you're going to do that, make sure they're sitting in a closed container because they won't stink up the fridge, and they won't suck in all the smells of the fridge, right? So that was done. Let me do clear up some more space for us. Yes, sir. I'm always interested in those kinds of topics. Awesome. Yeah, that was a great topic. And that was thanks to Riot. I believe Riot recommended we do. So we ended up doing. Let's throw these guys in. Too much splatter. And what I'm gonna do now is just basically trying to free up space so we can chop up the other onion. Right? What I'm gonna do now is kick up the temperature. I'm putting it on medium heat, this guy here now, right? Because I got the onions in there. Let me give it a nice little shake. I've heard a spoonful of you in your mouth will stop it, but I don't think that's true. I've had very success with chewing gum while, oh, chewing gum. That'll get the juices flowing and make the, that's mainly in the mouth. Or I guess the mouth, the nose, and the eyes. They're definitely connected, the nose and the eyes. One of the crazy things that is weird, when I was younger, I remember this. Used to be able to do, you could hold your nose and blow into your nose, and you could see it, feel a little bit of air through the crowd. It was weird. In the eye, just on the inside there, it was interesting. I don't know why that memory stuck with me. Let's get this going. After this, we're gonna cut up some potatoes. Hello, Spotify. How are you doing? Lego today? Chopping onion ASMR would be cool. That'd be a lot of tears, though. Might be cool, though. I just tried to do that eye trick now. Can't do it. Yeah, I think what happened was when I was younger anyway, I guess the body's developing. So as I got older, I can't do it anymore. I haven't been able to do it since I was like a little kid, right? think just everything grows and things close up. Ooh, I'm actually getting a little teary up. To build. Oh no! I do it all the time. I like the sensation. Can you shout? I can't hear you. Oh yeah, I'm talking pretty softly today. Sorry, gang. I'm all chill. Let me give these guys a little wipe. Chop up onions, I try to give the board a wash pretty quickly. I don't want the onion juice to be sitting on the board too long. The ASMR is best through the headphones. Yeah, but today in general, Casey, I've been very soft-spoken for some reason. Just relaxed, chill, I guess. I love going to the kitchen, so it really calms me down. I got headphones max volume. Okay, what are you saying? The onions are the best. Okay, WX, I gotta be able to read your name. Lock ZTV. WX, Lock. Okay, my name. You gonna chop some more onions? No more onions, that's it. However, I am gonna chop up some potatoes. I can hear it great half volume. Maybe check the app. Nah, it's full. Yeah, some volumes. I know one of my computers, my own ASMR videos, I can't really watch them because it's too low volume. Ah, Casey, it's okay with Locke. Kung Fury. I've seen parts of it, I think. Kung Fury, that rings a bell. Kung Fury. Onions is hate now. Dang it. Thanks, Dr. P. Yeah, Locke. The reason we're pretty hair trigger on this the stream, because we've had some trolls come in that were pretty nasty. So we're not into just, we don't even want to open the door for that, right? Because unfortunately, there's some weak. And we're gonna cut these potatoes. Check this out. We're cutting these potatoes fairly thin. I'm gonna cut them actually thinner than this, okay? Because we're gonna lay these things under one of the pans that we have. I'll show you once we do it, okay? Once we cut these up. So I'm gonna try to cut these up a little thinner, okay? And I'll show you what we're gonna do with this. Love me some turmeric with potatoes. Yeah, we're gonna use turmeric actually, Dr. P. Not a good idea to say stuff like that too much. Kung Fury, the best thing I've ever seen. I got to get going. Got real hungry. No worries, Nikki. Hope you have a good meal. If you want to see what we've done, probably in two and a half hours we'll have it ready. Hopefully, anyway. So we got a fair bit of slices off one potato. All right, we're gonna do another one. I think we're gonna go through two. Nah, that's good. Awesome. Great. I'm glad everything worked out, gang, on the chat. Doop.
glass.
I'm kicking up the onions higher. I'm kicking it up to basically 8 out of 10 on the stovetop, okay? And I'm gonna bring out a little wooden spatula. That's what I usually end up using for these. Okay. And give this a nice little mix. If we have time, make a small dish of cuckoo as well. Okay. During the downtime, if we get everything done. Okay. We're gonna be doing chicken, cherry rice chicken dish. And there's a whole process to it. You gotta cook the chicken, cook the rice, and then put the things together and throw it into the oven. While the stuff is in the oven, I'm gonna try and make cranberry sauce, because one way you can eat rice instead of, if you don't wanna use cherries, you're gonna use cranberries. And I've never made the cranberry sauce. I just got the recipe from my mom and decided might as well try that out, buy some cranberries, right? Easy peasy, because cranberries, a lot of people, is easier access than cherries, and cranberries are delicious, right? And I always like to increase my repertoire. Things to make. And if we have more downtime while everything's cooking, we're gonna make some cuckoo, which is a Persian green with egg dish. It's sort of a quiche dish, but it's not really quiche. Onions just brings out the flavor, and when we layer the onion sauce that's going to be cooking here with the chicken on the bottom of the pan, it just adds so much flavor to that very thin layer in the bottom. It's really nice. Celery and carrot, always nice paired with onions. Yeah they are. Yikes. Hard to get cherries right now. I went and got some more frozen cherries. Cool. So let's do that. I'm gonna add some spices in here. Now usually I do this with just visually. I don't do measurements. However, I brought, I usually use a tablespoon, right? But I brought these two measurements and I did some calculations. So I'm gonna try to give you accurate measurements for these things, okay? Except for the dried mint and the rosemary. Now this is one of the jars of the dried mint that we had, that we made. I've gone through, I forget how many we made like 6 or 7. I'm down to 1, 2, 3. So this is basically down to 2.5. I got another half of one in there. It's a little bit more than that. Right? Hello, X. How are you doing? So we're down to about 2 jars of mint. I've been going through mint like mad. Okay, loving it. So this is the dried mint that there's a video out there showing you guys how I end up drying the mint and stuff, right? So let me put this on the side. Right now, I'm just gonna add a little bit of dried mint. And I usually just take the stem like this, right? And I just hold it up here and I just go crumble, right? Okay. And I don't throw the whole stem in there, right? This compost. I'm gonna do a little bit more. Actually, I'm gonna do the rest of this when I put the chicken in. So let's put this in here. I'm gonna throw in a little bit of rosemary as well, and I will do again more when we put the chicken in. Hello from Sweden. Hello, Sweden. Hope you have a fine evening. Cheers. Cheers, Sweden. Thank you for popping by. Let's throw some rosemary too. Just, you know, a couple of stems like this. Just throw that in. And about half of that. Okay. That's enough. That's enough for now. When we put the chicken in, we'll see what the stuff looks like. Let's close this up. Give it a shake. Nice. Now this thing's cooking on. I'm kicking this up to high heat, okay? Because I want to get it going. And I'm going to take the potatoes and I'm going to lay down on the tray here, okay? And I'm going to show you what I'm going to do. We'll do this tray with potatoes, okay? And we're going to do this one. We're going to make two dishes, okay? We're going to make this one with flat bread on the bottom. Okay. Right now we've got the potatoes cut up, so let's take care of those. Give my hands a little wipe. So the order of business is, take some olive oil, pour it on top of the pan, or at the bottom of the pan, right? Just enough so when you put the potatoes in, they soak in, right? They're nice and oily. That's what you really want. So here's one potato, right? We'll see how much this takes. And all I do is just rub it around a little bit so I know it's gonna be all covered with oil, the bottom of the pan, right? You can flip the potatoes, you don't need to, because it'll suck in the juices, it'll be good enough. So line the bottom of the tray with potatoes. Okay. These might be a little thick. I cut them. But that's okay as well. Let's put the thinner one there. Let's find... And you want to fill up all the empty spaces, right? I do anyway, because I like the potatoes at the bottom. So what you can do is just break them, right? And just fill them in, if you can. Okay. Fill it in. And I'll bring it over so you see more, right? The end pieces you can use as well. Yeah. We don't need to go. We got one more potato cut up here, right? So I cut up a little bit too many potatoes. That's okay. And then on top of this, we're going to be putting on the chicken, right? With the sauce over top of it, right? So that's that. That's good. Now you can throw on a little bit of salt if you want. Lucas, how are you doing? Good evening to you. You can throw on a little bit of salt, right? Really, you don't have to, but all I'm going to do is just going to go very gently, not much. That's it. It's not even a pinch, okay? So this is ready for the next phase of these things, right? We've done the cuts, we've used up the potatoes, we've got this many potatoes left, okay? What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put these potatoes in a tray with a lid on it so they don't go black, okay? So I'm just gonna put it in this. You could put water in this and then put the potatoes in if you like, but the odds are I'll cook these up later anyway, so they're not gonna sit around in the kitchen and get dark. I can smell the onions right now. So I'm gonna kick down, like cooking in the bottom, right? Because you do want it to get a little black. You see that? Little burnt. Not much. Like, really, not even burnt. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to add a little bit of water. Okay. I'm going to put the chicken on top. So what is our water thing? Usually I don't have so much stuff laid out, so this guy's close to me. So a little bit of water. Now, let me show you the chicken. This is 8 chicken legs, okay? And I took out the fat on them yesterday. Do you get all the things out of your own garden? No, not everything out of my own. The mint, yes. The rosemary, yes. The spice, some of the spices, yes. But no, I wish. But a lot of the stuff is local. Like, this is local chicken. Potatoes are local organic potatoes. What else are we using? The onions are local organic onions. Okay, so we try to get as much local as possible. Extra potatoes, boil them up with some cabbages, sprouts, and have bubble and squeak for breakfast. Bubble and squeak, is that what it's called? So here's how much fat I took off 8 chicken legs. Okay. And I usually do try to trim the fat off the chicken or meats in general. And what I do with this, I put this in the freezer. When the time comes to either garbage or compost, we put it in there, send it off. If it's compost, we dump it out of the plastic, right? So let's throw this in the freezer. I just kept that to show you guys. Now the chicken we're going to put in here, okay? Let's crack this open. I'll show it to you. Take a look. No, I haven't added anything to this. No spices, no oil, nothing, right? All I did was take the skin off and give it a wash. So after taking the skin off, I rinsed all of these chickens, okay? So all I'm going to do is, actually I'm going to give it another shake. Good. I just want to check the bottom, make sure the onions is not sticking, okay? And what we're gonna do is just throw the chicken in there. And right now I have the stove at half mid temperature. It's an amazing breakfast and super easy. Cool. Cabbages, sprouts. What type of sprouts, Casey? So that's my chicken. Put this in the pan. And what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna take the turmeric and I'm gonna put some on top of here. Okay. I'm gonna use spoonfuls. Usually I just pour it freehand, right? But I wanna use spoonfuls so we know how much we're using. Actually, let me use this. So we use exact measurements. This is, I forget what this one was. This is 1/8 of a cup, okay? So 1/8 of a cup. Let me see how much I'm gonna take. I'm gonna take 1/8 of a cup and spray it on top of the chicken. And that's plenty. I usually put a little bit less. So 1/8 of a cup of turmeric or less if you don't want. I'm gonna take a little bit of basil, okay? I just looked up bubble and squeak. Sounds like a good breakfast, cool. So this is just basil. I'm just gonna free pour this, okay? That's probably a teaspoon, okay? And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna throw in some more rosemary and a little bit of more mint on top. Let's do rosemary. Okay, I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna dump this on top. Actually, half of this. It already has a fair bit. So I took half of it and dumped that on top. And I'm gonna take more mint and dump it. I'm taking basically the rest of this. Sure, the rest of this, why not? Let's make it minty. I'm gonna take the rest of this, or half of this, let's say. Half of it is good. About this much more, I'm gonna dump it on top of the chicken. Okay. And break it up. The stems go into compost. And we're gonna pour a little bit of water. Cool. Now we're gonna let it cook. And I'm gonna kick up the temperature to about 7 out of 10. Okay? Bread and cheese is breakfast if all you need is all you need. And honey. Bread, cheese, and honey is amazing. So let's put this on the side. We're done with this. We're gonna cook the rice, okay? So let me grab this cutting board out of here. And what I'm gonna do now, since the cutting board is out of there, I'm kicking up the temperature on here into the larger element, because right now, here, I'll show you. It's the small element cooking, so I'm kicking up to the larger circle, right? Hopefully it'll turn on. You'll see it, and I'm gonna put it on 6. Okay, so it'll heat up, and I'm gonna give this a wash and put the. Actually, the first thing I'm gonna do is put the chicken container into the dishwasher. That way we're not contaminating anything else. How are you doing? May as well make it a plowman's lunch if you have the bread and the cheese already. Plowman's lunch. I gotta look these up. Plowman's lunch. So let's close this guy. And this cutting board we don't need anymore, so we're gonna put this back. Okay, and this guy we're gonna give a rinse. Now we're gonna bring the other pot here and heat this up. I'll link my British nonsense on Discord. Done deal. Oh, I should be moving the chat up. My apologies. Check this out. I forgot to take care of this business. Let's move the chat up. I gotta resize it. Hopefully that'll work. That's one thing I had planned on doing. I forgot to do. So we want the width to be about 600. Hopefully it'll adjust it. It doesn't need a restart, then I won't gonna restart it. Let's make that 700. See if it works. Ah, perfect. So that should be good. That way, lock that up. Let's do a little test. Test. Where is that test popping up? There it is. Okay, perfect. Hopefully that's easier to read, gang. Okay, we got that. We got this. Let's check this out. Nice. So I'm cooking it hard, right? It's got water in the bottom, so it's going to soak up the juices. And I'm going to add more water as well. A little bit. I'm going to add a little bit of olive oil. I should add a little bit of olive oil right now. Okay. I should have probably added a little earlier, but it is what it is. It is what it is. Water-wise, it doesn't need. It's the curdling. I can see the curdling going on. As long as you can see the curdling happening, it's good. So the chicken is cooked, so I don't have to worry about dealing with raw chicken. And in general, I want to cook it where the meat is coming off the bones really easy, because the meat we end up using to make broth. Sorry, the bones we end up using to make broth, and the meat comes off easy. We're gonna layer it at the bottom of the pan on top of the potatoes and on top of the bread. So now we can start using this stove. I'm gonna kick this up high. This is like turbo boil, so it's like crazy heat, right? So I'm gonna kick it on super high right now for like a couple of minutes. And then I'm gonna bring it down to midway. Or at least until it starts boiling. That'll give us enough time to wash the rice. Where's our lid? So I use just basically long grain rice, basmati rice. Okay, I don't want the rice to be sticky. I want it to be longer grains. Will you be doing broth today? No, no broth today. Broth, I usually cook broth for 12 to 24 hours, right? At least 10 hours. I always plan to make a broth and then get crazy and buy some stock. No, I don't like the stock cubes. They're not. I don't like them at all. I'm gonna take the rice. I'm gonna use probably two, I'm gonna use 2 cups. So here's 1 cup, right? I might use 2.5. Here's 2 cups. Let's use 2.5 cups. That's a lot of rice, but I'm going to be making 2 dishes, right? So 2.5 cups. I need to take care of this. Now, this thing hasn't touched raw chicken yet, but it is now, so I'm gonna keep that in mind, right? The bottom is sizzling. So, get the mint off that. What I'm gonna do is, I'm kicking this down. It was sitting around 7 out of 10. I'm kicking it down to 5 out of 10. Okay. Thank you, Tony, for the Twitch Prime sub. Yeah, they suck. I just never leave myself enough time to do it properly. What bone broth? Usually, I use a slow cooker. I've used these pans as well to cook broth. Chicken bone, basically. So take a look at this. What I do with the rice, I put it in a bowl and I run cold water on it, and it gets murky. I'm gonna mix this up with a spoon. It gets murkier. I'm gonna dump out the water, and then I'm gonna do it again. I'm gonna keep on doing it until I can see the rice fairly clearly. That way, I've cleaned up the rice. Okay. melt off the bone. Not even I can mess it up. Nice. I usually, there's a few different things that we do with chicken bones. I'll show you guys another way we use chicken bone. We buy chicken bone and use it up. So take a look at this. It gets murkier, right? It's dirty, it's dry. So we're gonna do this again. And the beauty of it is, you can just pour the water out. The rice is heavy enough that it sinks. Do this while I'm reading the chat. Yeah, always marinate poultry. It's a must for me now. Yeah. Well, for this one, I didn't marinate it. This one, I'm gonna cook it hard. Right. Buttermilk fried chicken was my first moment of buttermilk fried chicken. I've never tried. Yeah, so bad plus good. So you can see it's still getting, still same level of murkiness, right? That's three times, still murky. I'm gonna do this here so we can go faster and run more water. Take a look at this. This is less murky, right? So I'm gonna let it sit a little bit while I take care of this stuff. I'm gonna give this one a mix again. I'm gonna turn down the heat on this. I'm kicking it down to 4 out of 10, but this is a hot element, this guy right here. Okay. This guy I'm gonna mix up again. Just made a curry with a vegetable chicken substitute. My question is, do you know what the brand is over in Canada and UK? We use Quran. What kind of, oh, the curry? Is that what you're asking, Tony? What the curry brand is? Pretty hard, so I'm gonna kick it down to 4 out of 10. I'd love to find sub meat that can get the family to eat. Try to cut down on meat. Oh, is this the meat thing? Chicken substitute. Oh, vegetarian chicken substitute. Quran. It's called Quran, really? This thing is nicely boiling. Let's kick this down. Okay. And let me show you the rice. It's still murky, but less so. I'm gonna give it a couple more rinses. Now take a look at this. Way less murky, right? So that's good enough for me. Okay. So all we gotta do now is this hot. That's good. Okay. Now remember, I've kicked this temperature down, the boiling water, right? Now don't go crazy with it because steam burns, okay? And pour it in gently so you don't get splatter. You can take some of the hot water inside, but make sure you don't burn your fingers and grab up the rice, right? Because you can easily use water to transport rice. Comes off pretty easy. Okay, you don't need a spatula. Now I got a ton of water here, which is okay for now. I'll deal with it soon. Okay, I'm gonna pour some of it out. When I put the rice in the pot, I never close off the lid completely. When it's cooking, I leave air so water evaporates because rice tends to foam up and you get spillage happening. It's like pasta, right? So I don't want that to happen, to create a mess, right? So I'm gonna leave this lid open. Sometimes the steam pushes the lid closed, so keep an eye on it. And this rice, I'm not gonna cook completely. I'm gonna cook to a level where it's like pasta alla dente, I think that's what it's called, where it's a little, not hard, but it's not completely cooked because we are gonna put it into the oven as well. Searched, I can. I didn't know you were streaming for sure. Do you want me to sing for you? We're making pizza today. No, we're making Serge Tankian homeland food, Persian dish, not Armenian, but Persian dish. Quran said, it's spelled that way. K Warren is very good in my experience, although I prefer to either have meat or use beans or vegetables rather than a substitute. I'm the same. I just prefer my curry. What Quran is that? Wow, okay. Is it borscht? No, not borscht. For us cooking, we're cooking I don't know if you're asking me, but cherry rice chicken dish. Yeah, I understand that. Curry benefits from something denser. I have a hard time with the dry beans. Getting it right. Love them. Terrible at cooking them. Soaking beans is good. Soaking beans overnight, sometimes 2 days if you soak beans. Hey, brother. Hello, still. Still a champ. How are you doing? Very true. Welcome to all of the Chicho mathematics out there in the Chicho verse. Curl Jog, you're back. How you doing? How's life? Fun stuff. Fun stuff, man. Fun stuff. So let's see. This is, you can see with the rice cooking, you can see it getting a little murky now, right? I'm gonna give it a little stir, right? I guess it's a spin as well. With a bigger spoon, right? Just to make sure the bottom of the pan, the rice is not sticking, because I did have this on fairly high temp, right? Usually I give a stir right away, but it is what it is. Can you turn the sound up or speak up? I'm speaking as loud as my natural state allows me to speak to a certain degree. I can speak a little louder. The problem with doing the stuff in the kitchen, if I turn up the volume really high, the kitchen sounds can be quite overwhelming, right? Because I do bang things around. So I don't want to do that because we are sort of doing a little ASMR version of things as well, right? Keeping it nice and chill. Spin it's ASMR, try headphones. Instant pot pressure cookers, yeah, pressure cookers are amazing. Of course, yeah, pressure cookers are phenomenal. Let's bring out another. Be careful going by the pots because there's steam hitting. You don't want to burn. I felt a little heat, so I pulled away fast, right? So don't do that. Let's give this another stir. Nice. And I give this a stir so the bottom is not sticky. Okay. And it's getting a little bit sticky right now. So I'm going to give it a little bit more water. Okay. And I'm going to kick the temperature really low. I'm kicking the temperature down to 2 out of 10. gonna give it. It still had plenty of water there, but I don't want to accidentally dry it up. A little bit more. Cool it down. I never thought of that, soaking beans. Yeah, soaking beans is huge, especially, is it called garbanzo, the chickpeas? To do is clean up as I'm going. So, you know, bowl that we use to clean the rice is clean. I just give it a nice little wash. Good afternoon, QC Warrior. How are you doing? Welcome to another stream. What are we cooking today? Cherry rice chicken dish, a Persian dish that we're gonna make with a chicho twist on it, I guess. Okay. I'm gonna dump some of the water out of the rice. Take a look at that. Nice. I'm gonna give it a little bit of spin again. Make sure the bottom's not sticking, and it's not. Right. Now the rice is gonna soak up a lot of this water. But let's take this out. Let the curdling stop, the boiling stop. Dump a little out, bring it back. Didn't dump too much, just enough. You want, on top of your rice, depending on the size of the bowl you're using, you want a little bit of layer of water so the rice is going to soak it all up. Okay? Let's do that. Let's have a sip. Lemon liqueur, right? Delicious. Delicious. So this is the lemon that's been from the liqueur that I made 8-9 years ago, right? It's good for digestion, really. Moroccan style hummus yesterday, nice. What does Moroccan style hummus have? The way I make hummus is basically cayenne pepper, lemon. Oh, we're gonna put some lemon in here. I forgot about that. Lemon, salt. It doesn't have very many things. Thank you for a follow, Rupel. Hello, my lord. Hello, Rupelo. How are you doing? Gotta cook your own beans if you make hummus. No? What's your best dish? Is that going out to me, brother or sister? My best dish. My best dish. What is my best dish? My best pastry that I can make is called the nazuk. It's an Armenian pastry. It's brilliant. It's a major process. I'll show it to you guys one day. And it's phenomenal, okay? And I make it better than my whole family, and everyone knows it. So, just cut a lemon. I'm gonna squeeze this into a cup. So squeeze it into this. So I'm just gonna squeeze this into the thing. Lemon juice, cumin. Yeah, lemon juice for sure. Turmeric. Wow, turmeric. Paprika as well, eh? Salt and pepper and garlic infused olive oil. Wow, garlic infused olive oil. We use just fresh garlic, lemon juice for sure, cayenne pepper, no turmeric, no cumin, no paprika, and salt, no pepper other than cayenne pepper. I'm gonna squeeze another one too. When I, so humble, I know, index. I took a long time to perfect that recipe, man. The nazuks. It's the pride of Armenian cooking. I think the family might be lying though. The reason they say I make the best because they want me to make it because it takes a long time to make. It's this huge song and dance. So I'm gonna pour. This much lemon juice, 1 teaspoon. That's it. Nothing else. And let's give it a mix. Sitting in juices, right? I'm gonna add a little salt. Actually, before I do that, let's check on this. This thing is on 4, but it's going crazy. And I'm gonna taste the rice right now because I don't want to overcook it. Really important not to overcook it. I'm just gonna grab some with a fork, right? You can just go like this. And I can tell it's not cooked enough yet, right? Blow on this. How long have you been vegetarian? Someone's vegetarian. Constantly prep to make a batch. How long does it take to cook? I lost the conversation, so I'm not. Oh, the pastry? Oh. When you do a full-on batch, I do like quadruple batches. Quadruple batch takes prep time when you're putting it all together. The nazuks, putting it all together takes 2 to 3 hours, and then the cook time takes another hour to 2 hours, depending how many batches you're doing. And you got to be on the ball when you're doing it. And you need space. You need lots. Like, we don't have enough space to make the recipe I have here. Okay, we need a bigger kitchen. I'm not anymore what I was. Fair enough. This is difficult. This is a veganism, vegetarianism. Cool. So this guy's cooking. Nice. That guy's doing his thing. What were we about to do? We were about to do something. What was it? Oh, the rice is cooking. Dude, you look like my uncle. Nice. He must have a beautiful goatee. Purple, what's it called? Turnip. Purple turnip. Spicy, delicious. Take a look. Beautiful. Very cool looking. Looks cooler than it tastes, but it's beautiful. I'm with Casey. I used to eat out a lot, but I can't eat out too much anymore. Not that. Your uncle has good taste in hats. Oh, wow. Every other week, Tony, you cook for yourself. That's it. Yeah, but you're traveling, so. It's difficult to eat well when you're traveling, unless you're bringing your own supply and you have specific places you go to, you know the restaurants in that area. So check this out. The rice is expanding now, right? It used up all the water. This should be cooked now. I'm gonna grab another fork. Stress made you lose your appetite. That's not good. Just start cooking. Cooking relieves stress. Just start off slow. I'm just gonna try a little bit. Yeah, that's good. Turning the rice off. right? I love it when I do get to cook, though. I made an amazing banana loaf on Sunday. Nice. Chocolate banana loaf or straight up banana loaf? I like banana loaves. I need to rinse out the rice. I'll look into that. Is it cool? So I need to rinse out the rice. So what I'm gonna do, here's my little screen. So I'm gonna put this on here, put it in the sink, and I'm gonna pour the rice on top of this. Now, the amount of rice I have is more than this, so I'm gonna have to do it twice. And every time I get this sort of filled up to about this level, not full full, right? Give myself a little space. I'm gonna rinse water on top of it because I wanna rinse out the stickiness of the rice. Okay. I'll send you a link. It was just a banana loaf, but I am going to have to make a chocolate and banana one now. So let's put this here. Let's bring this here. Let's take this guy here. Let's grab our mittens. And you can see is the rice has used up a lot of the water, right? And we've turned it off because we don't need it anymore. Take a look. All right. I'm gonna dump that out as well as soon as I give this rice a little rinse. Larger glass dish, so I'm gonna pour the rice in there. Okay. Give it a little shake, get it in the water. And you wanna handle rice gently once you cook it because it is fragile, right? So don't go ballistic with a spoon on it and to a certain degree and squish it down and stuff because it will, you know, rice and grains is nice. Take a look. I should have shown you this before. When you pour out the rice, all the little rice grains are stick at the bottom of the pan, right? And you don't want to do that. You don't want to scoop them out with a spatula. All you do is just pour water on top and grab them. You just swirl it and grab all the rice and pour it through the strainer. You might have to do it a couple of times. And you get most of the rice, and I'm going to clean that up. Give it another rinse. So we get this, and you gently pour it out. Okay? That's how much rice we ended up getting. It's a fair bit, but we're gonna make two bowls. There's gonna be a little bit of rice in the big bowl as well that I have in the sink, but I'll see how much it is as soon as I pour out the water, if it's worth keeping or not. I was pretty careful, so we didn't get that much rice, so I'm not gonna bother putting that with the rest of it. Okay. I'm just gonna wash these out. The screens are like washing right away because things get between them, stuff like this, and it's just easier in the long run. These guys, the pots is okay. I can do a wash on these. Actually, this one I can. Yeah. We'll put this on the side. Let's throw this here. We I'll give it a nice wash later, but I am going to put water in this guy, the pan that we need the rice. Okay. I've started cooking more lately. Little joke. I made the sauce by pork chops. Soup by pork chops with a Dijon mustard. Nice reduction. Probably the best thing I've ever accidentally made. Some of the best foods are accidental makes. Fine. I'm sorry. Vacuum sealing food. I had to look that up. Yeah. I love cooking with it now. Makes perfect temperature steaks and chops every time. I just fill them up. Fill them up by sealing a hot cast iron. See that ball? I'm gonna look into it. What's the conversation there? I'd 100% invest in Solvite if I could. What is Solvite? I don't know what that is. Yes. Vault. Covered in the sauce. Okay. And if you want a strong little sauce taste, the sauce there is amazing. Now, that's basically cooked. The chicken, to a certain degree, chicken needs to cook more, but the sauce and everything's cooked. This I was using when the chicken was raw. I'm gonna put this in the sink and bring in new spatulas and new plates. Okay. Before I do that though, I'm gonna just give the pot a wash where we cook the rice. It's easy to do. Put this guy away so it's out of our hair. I might need it again when we're doing some of the other stuff, but probably not. Can use the smaller cutting board. I bear it out. Let's check it out. Cool. Now, we got that going. This is cooking away. I'm going to turn on the oven. Okay. I'm going to put it on bake. I always check the oven to make sure there's nothing in there. Okay, sometimes I just put things in there that are randomness, right? Pots and pans, of course, right? Bake, I'm going to put it on 420. Okay. I think from now on we might be cooking everything at 420, but we'll see where we go with it. Apologies about the sound, because the fan automatically kicks in for the stove. Okay, so I'll talk a little bit louder. If it's getting, if you can't hear me, just let me know. I'll talk louder as well. Okay, kick it up a notch further. Okay, so what we need. General that's touched raw chicken, I try to get rid of right away, right? Put away anyway. I'm gonna order a pizza tonight, so I think I'm gonna be a bit lazier than you. What's Casey gonna cook? Cast iron shouldn't reach much iron when searing, I don't think. Not if it's seasoned properly. Mainly happens within liquids, the cast iron. Cooking sounds are so relaxing. Indeed, indeed. Hello, Livia. How are you doing? Welcome to another live stream. All right. Where do we put this guy? Let's bring this guy out. Let's take a look at the chicken. cook it more. The chicken's not cooked perfectly yet. Let's cook it a little bit more. Let's put this guy here. Okay. So we're basically set for the chicken. What I'm going to do with the rice, right? We just need the chicken to cook more. I'm gonna kick it up a notch. I'm gonna put it on 3 out of 10. I play around with the temperature a fair bit, okay? Now what I'm gonna do with the rice, first of all, I'm gonna taste it, see what the consistency is. Chicho, is there a specific bread that you usually serve with Armenian dishes? Yeah, in general, it's just flat bread. It's nothing fancy. I'll show it to you guys when we layer the other pot. This is not bad. But I'm gonna put this guy here for now. I'm gonna bring out the cherries. I'm gonna mix it in there. Okay. The bread is this, usually, in general. Some version of this, right? You can have it like flat bread like this. It's got little holes in it and stuff. Or, you know, general pita bread. Personally though, I love this. I eat this type of bread a lot. It's simple, you don't eat too much bread. It makes amazing bottom tray dish for rice. But personally, I love sourdough. I eat a lot of sourdough. Sourdough bread is, sourdough toasted up, heated up. If you can get fresh just out of the oven, amazing. With butter and honey on top. Frozen cherries. Okay, let me show you how much I'm going to use. And we'll see if we're going to use more or not. And I'm not going to use it for all of this. Because some of this I want to save just as white rice. Okay. Sourdough is incredible. Yeah, love sourdough. Oops. Okay. I want to save some of this rice, white rice. So let's do this. I want the tray to have lots of, mix it in with lots of cherries. This is good. Okay, we're gonna put this on the side. Let's see how much cherries we're gonna be using. So, okay, so I have this much rice. We took out about a third of it. So if we use 2.5 cups of rice, about 3/4 of a cup just went over there, and we got 1.5 cups of rice here. Let's see how much cherries we're gonna add. Here's 1 cup. Here's 2 cups. Mix this up to see how it looks. So we got 2 cups of cherries in there. Okay, frozen cherries. And be careful mixing this up. Some people don't mix it up like this. They put a layer of rice on top of the chicken and the bread and stuff, and then they put cherries on top, and then they put another layer of rice. I mix it up. Keep it simple. I'm gonna add more cherries. So we have 2 cups. And some people like a lot of cherries with the rice, some people like less. So per taste. Making your own sourdough, man, I wish I was making my own sourdough. Getting a good sourdough starter is definitely something I'd like to do. Broad maker, wow, I've never made. So here's 3 cups. And you know what, let's finish off this guy. A couple of these, I'm gonna give them prints. basically three cups. I mean, look at this. There's only a handful in here. So we're going to dump that in there. So three cups of pitit. There's no pits in here. The packet says you could find pits, but that's just the luck of the draw, right? You want it to be pitted. You don't want to be biting down on pits when you're eating this thing. And the color of the cherries sort of goes with the rice. And once it does that, I'm not going to mix it anymore, right? I don't want the rice to go completely red. I want a little whiteness in there. And when it's going to cook, there's going to be more bleeding of the color as well. Okay. That's the algorithm to a semi-decent cook. 420? Is that what it is? Sourdough starters. Where's the sourdough starter? Let's bring up a fork. When I think the chicken is ready, I'm going to use a fork just to peel off the chicken to see if it is. Okay? I'm going to start gaming for a bit, but going to keep listening. Awesome. Hope you have a good game, Tony. The message is... Let's check this. See that? The bone is, the meat is coming off. I'm going to cook this a little bit more as well, I think. Pretty cooked nicely. Right, that's cooked pretty nicely. Okay. Let's do the next phase. Okay. Let's do the next phase. Now, let me put this guy out. We're gonna bring this here. Because I had the temperature on here, it's still a little hot, right? Don't do that unless you know your stove well. I'm gonna put the cast iron here, and then I'm gonna put the cutting board on top of it. That way we're not putting wood on top of a heat, right? I just got my first win, Apex Legend. Let's put this guy here. I'm gonna bring the chicken here, and we're gonna take out the meat. Down to low now, okay. And let's remove this. The more you cook it, the easier the chicken comes off, obviously, right? So we can leave that there. Let's just pull these guys off. Let's see what you can see. Conversation is always good. Okay. And the bones I'm going to put into another bowl. Let's put them on to, let's put them in this bowl. Because after this, the odds are I'm going to bring in the slow cooker and just throw the bones in there. We have a little bit of this guy no more. We'll put the bones in this. And get rid of this guy. Right. That should be enough to catch all the bones there. So And the oven is getting closer to 420. It's at 375 right now. Let's bring this out. This chicken would be amazing roasted as well. We're going up to at least 2.5 hours stream today, possibly 3 hours. I'm gonna do it long enough, to a certain degree, hopefully anyway, where we get the browning happening at the bottom of the pans for the potatoes and the bread. Hopefully we get it happening. Sometimes you gotta leave it in there an hour and a half. I might kick up the temperature. If it's not happening, well, it might not. I might have to kick up the temperature. Hopefully we won't burn it. Okay. Risky thing to do, but it is what it is. It is what it is. Already done your prep for your next cook as well, which is the broth. You know, there's still flavor in there. Rosemary and mint or turmeric with the bones, and there's a little bit of meat in there, and there's still a little bit of fat. And you got the sauce here, right? We'll taste the sauce. See what the sauce is like. Almost at 420, so our timing's pretty good. There we go. And this was the last chicken we had, right? So let's do this. That's good. Perfect. And there shouldn't be any bones here, but there might be. So you have to be careful when you eat the chicken. And here's the sauce. I'm turning this off now, okay? Let's do a little taste of this, see what it's like. Chicken there. Let's bring that out. I might take a look. Nice sauce. Lots of turmeric in this one, right? Chicho and sapto. I'm hungry too. Very good. Could use salt. So, we're gonna do this. Here, I'm gonna do it. I didn't add enough salt for sure. So I'm gonna add how much salt we're gonna add. I'm gonna measure this. Let's say that's plenty, and I'm going to add some salt on the chicken. Make it salty. Why not? Salty is good. Yeah, add a little bit more on this side and load up. Nice, nice, nice. So let's say a teaspoon of salt. Okay. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to mix this up so the salt's in there. Here's the bones. We're gonna put this on the side. We're gonna use later. Okay. Now, let's take our chicken. Let's put it over here. Enough space. Let's have a little sip of lemon liqueur before we do the next phase. Salute. So what I'm gonna do right now is put a layer of chicken, right? Let's put this guy here. I'm gonna save enough chicken to be able to do one more pot as well, and I'll show you which pot we're gonna use. I'm gonna divide this out evenly, right? Lay it out evenly. So I'm saving about this much for the other pot. Okay. Let's bring the knife. Let's spread this out. Okay. You could have cooked more chicken. For me, this is plenty. But you could definitely cook more chicken. And you don't even have to cut it up. You can just put whole chickens at the bottom of this, right? Nice. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna bring, where's our spoon here? This guy. And I'm gonna scoop out the sauce and pour it on top, right? Look at that deliciousness. You know what? Let's put this into a smaller bowl. We don't need this guy. Let's put that guy away. Do we need this guy? Well, we need these guys for later, so let's put these guys here. Okay. Let's bring out another bowl. I'm gonna pour it in this. Okay. Use a spatula to get the rest of it out, because this is nice sauce. You don't want to lose this. So I'm going to fill the pot just full of water, that way we're doing cleanup as we go. Okay, let me show you the sauce. Now this is amazing, right? You could make some phenomenal soup with this as well, okay? And do whatever you want with this. We're going to pour this, not all of it, and not too much of the juice, more of the onions and the meat of it, right? Let that fill up. So I'm gonna show you this. I'm gonna do this because it's a little hot at the bottom. Here you look. Huh? Delicious. Actually, I can do it here. See? Huh? I'm gonna turn off this guy. Have the sound going crazy. Right. So this is the sauce, and I'm going to pour this on top. Not to cover it up completely, but just to have enough so it's spread out everywhere. Right. There isn't that much juice this anyway, so I don't have to be too careful with that. That's delicious. I'm gonna give it another taste as well with a little spoon. Let's try this out. Fantastic. Very happy with it. Okay. Now what we're going to do, actually I'm going to spread out a little bit more on the sides as well. So we get enough of everything in there. Okay. Cool. Now we're gonna bring the rice with the cherries and we're gonna layer it on top. Okay. We can turn this guy off here. Let's turn off. Turn off the wrong one. Turn off this one. Okay. So let me layer this. Take a look. Right. Oh, I turned off the wrong one. What are we doing? What's going on? Let's turn off this one, right? So we're just gonna take this and just layer it on top. And I'll lift this up and I'll show you what it looks like once we get it done. Let's make sure the cherries are nicely distributed. Okay. Okay, that's plenty. Okay. And I'll lift this up and show you guys, and then we're gonna put foil on top of it. There's a little bit more left, but we'll. Let's use it all up. Let's fill it all up. We're gonna be eating this for 2 or 3 days. 3 days anyway. 3 days usually is the maximum I do things for leftovers. Okay. Nice. And I'm not destroying the rice, right? I'm not hitting it hard. I'm not pounding it. I'm just covering it gently. Okay. Chicho just wanted you to know your pomegranate video single-handedly got me to eat my first pomegranate and they became addicted to them. Awesome, cruel joke. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Okay. So let me show you this. This is what it looks like, right? We got the potatoes in the bottom. You can see. And we got the chicken layer, we got the sauce up top, on top of the chicken, and we got the rice and cherries on top, right? So I'm just gonna cover it up with foil, throw it in the oven. That's our dish. So we're gonna throw that in the oven. We're gonna put the timer on 45 minutes, right? So we're definitely going 2.5 hours stream, possibly up to 3 hours. Hopefully we'll get the bottom brown. If not, you'll get the idea of how it's supposed to work out. Okay, now. Here's the other thing we're gonna make. We're gonna do the same thing, but we're gonna layer it with the flatbread. Okay. So let me put this guy here. Okay, let's put it here. Make sure we're not making too many noises. Here, let's do it here. Too much banging noises. Okay. So what I'm gonna do right now is pour olive oil in the bottom. And this one we're gonna make with just simple flat bread, right? Not potatoes, but just flat bread. I'm gonna use this one. The one that's got little holes in it. I don't know if you can see it. See that? Little holes. I'm gonna soak it in olive oil. Make sure there's plenty of olive oil on there. And we've got a little bit of room here, so I'm gonna use it a little bit more. And I like this bread, it's delicious. You do want to cover the bottom with enough bread because this is called tadik and it tastes fantastic. Okay. Here, let's put this guy here. Let's take off this little piece. Okay. Next thing we're going to do, we're going to lay down the chicken on top.
Right?
So. Let's lay down the chicken up top. Okay. Let's put this up top. And then we're going to bring the sauce. And pour sauce on top. The bowl is still hot. Yeah, so I'm gonna hold it on the side. Yeah. And that's perfect. That's enough. And I'm gonna keep some. Might nibble on it later with bread. Just take bread and dunk it into this. Fantastic. Where did my bread go? Let me show you what it's like. Just take the bread. Yeah. Let's have a little food. Yeah, let me put this over here. Chicho, have you ever prepped this casserole and frozen it to bake it up? No, I've never done that. No. Yeah, take the bread, dump it in there. All right. It might be messy, but it is what it is. I'm gonna use a spoon to get the drips. And that's a dish on its own. Really delicious. And by the way, cruel joke, would you call this a casserole? I guess anything you put in the oven, it would be a casserole, yeah? In this format, I'm not sure. And then what I'm gonna do is just take the rice and just pour it on top. So, not a cherry rice chicken dish, just a simple rice. Because white rice is delicious. I'm a huge fan of white rice. Brown rice too, I'm just a huge fan of rice in general. Okay. You could fill this up to the top, but you know, we're out of rice. So we're just gonna do it like this. And some people put chunks of butter on top of this when they're cooking it and stuff. We're not gonna do that. It just becomes too much. Okay, it just becomes too much. Well, let's put this guy here. And give our hands a little wipe. And we have a lid for this. Where did my lid go? There it is. And I don't have to cover this foil, I have a lid. So I just put the lid up top and we've got the same thing going on. And it's bread at the bottom. Okay. And we threw that in the oven. And we're gonna let it cook. So So right now, we've got another 40 minutes to go from the first timer we set up, right? Let's put this guy here. We got time, right? A couple things we can make. Yo, I like your beer, bro. Thank you. I'm drooling. I'm seriously pretty hungry. For breakfast, I had yogurt and hemp seed and what did I mix with it today? With just mulberries. Okay, and it was really good. It was delicious. But smelling this, it's something else, right? It's something else. Now, one thing I want to make, and I've never made this, is cranberry sauce. And because the reason I want to make cranberry sauce is because you can eat the same dish with cranberry sauce instead of cherries. Now, it's not something that's traditional. It's something that just our family started doing. My mom started doing. And I asked her about it. She told me how to do it over the phone. So we're gonna do it. Okay. So this is, I'm just gonna use this tray, this bowl. Okay. Let's do it on this one, on this element here. Okay, let's turn this on, turn that off. Okay, you can see a little mess building up here slowly, right? I wanna take my sauce and put it on the side so it's not gonna get accidentally things in it. Okay, the potatoes, let's put in the fridge. So I went and bought myself some cranberries, okay, organic cranberries. I think it's my first cranberry purchase ever. Let's turn up the heat on this element, and I'm only gonna use the single element, not double element, right? So single element, I'm gonna put about a cup of water and about a 3/4 of a cup of sugar, okay? That's what the recipes call for. So let's do this. And we're not gonna cook the cranberries until they break down, they fall apart. Cast iron seasoning, game is on point. Nice. So take a look at this. So where's my cup? One cup is basically full on, right? So we're gonna take the full on. So that's about one cup, right? Throw that in there. This guy we don't need. Let's put this guy. Now we need the sugar. Right on. Greetings. Greetings, Yellow Pear. How are you doing? Welcome to another live stream. My sugar pretty tight so we don't have accidental spillage, but this is the same sugar we ended up using for the liqueurs. Okay, so let's throw in half a cup of sugar. Now that cup is wet, so I'm gonna use one of these guys, and about that's is deceptive. This seems bigger, but it's not. This much is about a cup. Right, so I'm gonna do about half of it or 3/4 of it. Cool. I'm gonna take this much. Right? It might be a little bit too much, but we'll see. We'll follow the recipes for now, right? This is my first time making it. I try to follow the recipes to a certain degree and then adjust accordingly, right? Later on. So let's do this. Kick up the temperature. And, how old are you, by the way? Somewhere between 18 and 99. Midway between 0 and 100. I'm gonna add a little lemon to this, okay, after it's melted. So let's do that. At the same time, while we're doing this, cruel joke. So what I'm gonna do is, while this is being melted and stuff like this, I'm gonna make a little bit of cuckoo because we got the time, right? If my math is correct, that would be 50. Half a century is a nice number, isn't it? And I'm gonna kick up the temperature on the oven, okay? Bake, I'm gonna kick this up to 450. I really want you guys to see the bottom of the pan getting crispy, okay? What a coincidence, my age also falls between those numbers. What are we gonna do? We're gonna bring up the, here we go, this is what we need. And if you guys remember, we made cuckoo before, okay? We got a recipe out there making some Persian cuckoo. It's a Persian veggie dish specifically, okay? Do I have enough to make it in a big pan? Let's check it out. So these are, you know, some of the greens that I still have left in the freezer. Every summer, you know, we buy greens, I chop them up, fresh greens, and I put them in the freezer and stuff like this. This one is just some of the greens. I put a label on here. This is dill, just dill greens plus dried dill, Italian parsley, and I think it's got cilantro in there as well, right? Here is a little, this one's got lettuce in there as well. It's sort of a batch that was a little extra left over from the previous cuckoo recipe, previous time I made cuckoo, right? So I just froze it, and I knew I was gonna make it again, so I have it in the freezer with the flour in there, right? So is this hot? That's not hot. Let's turn on this camera as well. Okay. So I'm gonna throw the greens in there. This has already been salted, this amount. Okay. I'm gonna throw these greens in there as well. Might as well use them up. Okay. For this, I'm gonna go throw in maybe 3-4 eggs. I'm not gonna add any more flour. This, what the recipe for this is, we have a video out there. Nice. The oven temperature just hit 450. This crispy rice on the bottom makes me think of Korean dish. Oh, bibimbap is amazing. So delicious. Oh, damn, Chicho. Hit us with the triple. Is that the dish super duper spicy? No, it's not spicy at all. It's flavorful, but it's not hot spicy, right? So what I'm gonna do, I might add a little bit more salt to this just because I added the greens, just raw greens. So I'm gonna add a little bit of salt. Okay. I'm gonna throw in 3 eggs in this. Okay. Let's throw in 3. Ooh, that's loud. Caught it. Oops. Did we lose this? No, we didn't lose that. That's good. So let's throw in 3 eggs in this. So here's the eggs, and I'm gonna mix them up. I'm just gonna clean off the eggshells and put the eggs away. Whenever I deal with eggs as well, I usually wash my hands afterwards, okay? So what I'm gonna do right now, I'm gonna add a little bit more flour to this. And right now, I'm just gonna add rice flour to this. Korean food I love, by the way, cruel joke. Korean food is, out of all the Asian foods, I like Korean the best. I think it's got the most amount of oomph to it. Okay, that's plenty. That's enough. So again, I'm just going by sight. So, all we gotta do is just mix this guy. So let's mix it up. I might add one more egg to this, we'll see. Once I mix it enough, we'll get the feel for it. Okay, cool. This is melted now, right? Boiled. What I'm gonna do is, the recipe says dump the cranberries in there, so we're gonna dump the cranberries. Tough. There. Gotta use your fingers to poke a hole in there. Right? Just straight up cranberries. So let's dump it in. Close the lid. And I'm going to kick down the temperature. That was sitting on 8 out of 10. I'm kicking it down to 4 out of 10. And let's keep on mixing this guy. I'm going to add one more egg. I want the texture to be more eggy. I guess I didn't need to bring the whole thing out. Let's bring this over. You want it to be in a way where the greens are getting nicely stuck together and it's sucking up all the flour. Okay. You could even add one more egg if you wanted to, but I'm gonna keep it like this. I don't want it to be too eggy. I'm gonna use a medium pan for this. That's good. Okay. I'm gonna use a fair bit of oil to cook this. So we don't need this guy. It's too big. Let's bring this guy out. Bring this guy. Cast iron is heavy. Give it a little rinse. Let's turn on the temperature. Remember, this element is hot. Hello, Eduardo, how are you doing? Salutations. Okay. So I'm kicking up, putting this one on medium. This one's cooking away because it was frozen. The temperature kicked down pretty fast, right? So let me give it a mix. Cool. I wanna cook this. Not until all the cranberries are mush, because it breaks down really fast. I still do want them to be, you know, some whole cranberries in there. All right, so let's put that guy there. Let's put that there. We got this guy kicked out. Okay. While we're doing this, I'm gonna make a little dish. So we got someone in the next room waiting for some food. We're doing a cut, so I'm gonna make a little dish for them so they can nibble on it. Okay, until the rest of the food is ready. That's the great thing with doing cooks and stuff, right? You can have little appetizers ready. as you're cooking, right? Just keep on tasting and sampling. Let's do this. Show you what I'm making. Okay. Just a little appetizer on the side, right? So I'm just gonna cut up some of the bread. Just along the, that's one of the reasons I like this bread. Along the dotted lines, right? Where it's already got like little holes in it. Okay. And I'm just gonna break it up like this. So it's just like bite size. Fast. Okay. So I'm gonna throw the, I gotta wait until the water completely, and I'm gonna kick down the temperature on this now, right? This stove is crazy hot, this element. Okay, crazy hot, this element. Cool. So let's put the oil on here. Hopefully there's no water on there. It's gonna go. Be careful when you do that. If you have water droplets on there, you put oil on there, it'll just go splatter everywhere and it'll get on your skin and burn you and stuff, right? And you don't want that. So bring out another spatula and we're just gonna pour this there and then form it. I could have definitely put it more egg in, but that's okay. I just want it to be mainly green. Okay. And then we're going to put the lid on it and let it cook. And it's going to cook fairly rapidly. And basically the type of flour I had in here before too, it was gluten-free flour. It was a mix of, I believe it was rice and a little bit of tapioca, so it gives it a sort of a squishy feel to it. Okay. So we have a lid here from before, we're just gonna close that up. Okay, so that's cooking. Let's take a look at the cranberries. I think I need to kick this guy up. We don't even got a curdling yet. Oh, it is steaming, so that's good. Just need a little mix. So let that, and you can smell the cranberries right now. X followed by the word video about it. What is it, the mix? Oh, that's why the Cruel Jokes, one of his comments got zapped. Casey approved it. Thank you, Casey. Okay, I'm gonna take a little appetizer to someone waiting in another room. If the cuckoo was made, I would put a couple of cuckoos in there. Right? Just a little bit of the sauce. Ideally, I would have a little cuckoo there, but we'll bring the cuckoos after it's made. Okay? Or how long is it going to take to make? Let's go surprise them with the full meal appetizer deal, right? Yeah, this guy's cooking. The cuckoo is going to take about 10 minutes. Okay. I don't know about the cranberry. This is my first time making this thing. So we'll find out. We got another 20 minutes in the stove. Let's make sure these guys are curdling. Yeah, they're curdling. Perfect. If you have stuff in the stove, what you can do, choo-choo. Thanks. If you have stuff in the stove, what you can do to make sure everything's at the right temperature, right cook and stuff like this, you can just open it up and take a look at the bottom. If you see a little curdling in the bottom, it's cooking well, right? We'll check it out in about another 15 minutes before the time is up. Okay. Let's see how this guy's doing. Want this to cook. Hopefully it's not, I didn't go too crazy with the high temperature. Sometimes I do that, I kick it up a little too high and it starts burning. Man, I bet the bread toasted in the oven with the dipping sauce would be insane. Yeah, it would be insane. That's one thing we do. I like, for me though, I like the flat bread just to be not crispy toasted. I like it to be heated, but still malleable, still foldable. That way I can just pour it with a spoon, scoop it up or whatever, right? Hey, let's do this. Let's bring this guy out. Let's bring in another plate for another spatula, for the cuckoo specifically. Okay. Let's bring in fresh knife. And a fresh fork. Let's see where we're at. You can smell, usually when you're making cuckoo, you can smell the greens cooking. Sometimes when they get burnt a little bit, you can smell it. Hey, Chicho, almost missed this one. Cooking streams are my favorite. Oh, Elvis, we've done a lot. We've been going at it for 2.5 hours now, I guess. I don't know, what time is it? What are we in? We're 2 hours and a few minutes. Do this. You can see it coming off, right? Hopefully. Right? And I'm gonna cut this. It's not done yet, I can tell, right? So let's let that cook. The bottom might have been a little bit too hot when I put the stuff in. I might have rushed it a little bit. So the bottom might be burning a little. Okay. If it is, it is what it is, right? If it is, it is what it is. Let's kick it down. I'm kicking this down to 3 now. Okay. This stove top is crazy. Oh, I can flip this. Let's try it out. Let's see if we can do a flip. Sorry, getting noisy. Let's see if we can do a flip on this guy. Not burning that bad. Let's do a little rotation. But it is burning. You can smell it, right? A little bit. So it's time to flip these guys. And what I'm gonna do now is, I'm gonna pour a little bit of olive oil on this. Maybe a lot of olive oil. Sometimes I cook this, lately I've been mainly cooking this, the cuckoos, with coconut oil, right? Usually you don't want the lid on here. I'm just putting it on here because it's getting a little splatter and I'm not wearing my bib and I don't want too much splatter going everywhere. I'll have to watch the entire video later. I hope you enjoyed it, Elvis. It's been fun. Went a little crazy. Initially, I was very chill when I started the day. I was talking very softly and gently. And, oh yeah, we wanted to remove this now. Because there's water from this dripping into that, mixing with the oil and splattering even more, right? So we put that there. Nice. Okay. And for this, with the cuckoo, I'm going to put a little yogurt on the side as well. Usually, in general, Eating grass-fed yogurt. Grass-fed yogurt. Grass-fed cows producing yogurt, right? It makes a big difference, and there's a certain vitamin you get from grass-fed cows that you don't get from, what do you call it? Grain-fed cows. I forget what the vitamin is. It's important. That looks good. I'm gonna turn this off. The cranberries, take a look. Okay. I don't want it to be completely squished, so I'm turning this off. I'm gonna leave the lid open a little bit. Okay. Here's a little spoon for the yogurt. And we're gonna check this out to see how our cuckoo's doing. Take a look. Looking good, looking good. Yeah, that looks good. Fantastic. Nice, nice. And what I'm gonna do now is just cut these one more level. Right? And by the way, thank you for the follows. Thank you for the subs. If I've been not catching them. Got a few different things going on, right? Started off nice and chill and I just went ballistic with this stuff, right? Perfect. Okay. Let's take a little snack. Keep them fresh, fork and knife, and let's turn this off now. We don't need to keep the cuckoo on. Take a look. Here, I'll show you here. This is what we got prepped. We got our sauce, right? Yogurt, cuckoo, and some flatbread to dip in the sauce, right? Nice little snack. Okay, but before I do this, one thing we forgot to do. Good thing I looked over there. I was gonna add a little lemon to the cranberry, right? So I'm gonna add a little lemon. I'm just gonna add this much. Okay. Actually, a little bit more. One more. Remember, this is my first time making this. And I'm not pouring it in because the seeds, there's seeds at the bottom of the thing, the lemon, right? Here, let's do half or more. Why not? I like it lemony. And let's close this. You're welcome. Thanks, Cruel Drunk. So let me take this to someone who's waiting for food as an appetizer. I'll be right back. Nice, they're super happy. Super happy. You gotta feed people when you can, right? You gotta feed people when you can. So we got this. So let me take the cuckoos and put them into this so they don't burn. Okay. Perfect, look at that. That looks great. Okay. Whoop, don't wanna lose it. these little bits here, they're super delicious. They're like crispy. So we definitely want to keep those as well. Cool. That's nice. Let's put our pan there. Let's give that guy there. We got a nice mess going on now. Just the way we like it. Oh yeah, we need this guy. Let's put this guy here. Okay. Now, here's our cuckoo. Okay, I'm just going to put it on the side. So let's put this guy here. Let's put it here. Nice. I'm going to bring out the rice dish. We're going to take a look to see what it's like. Chicho committing the ultimate sin. Metal spatula on cast iron. Is metal spatula not supposed to be on cast iron? Metal spatula, I heard, not on Teflon. Teflon, you don't do metal to Teflon. But I thought metal on cast iron was okay. Is it not okay? Cruel joke? If it's not okay, I'm going to stop doing that. But I've been doing it forever, for a long time. So, because we have the elements on, I'm going to put this on here. Because we're going to put, most likely, our... I always use metal too. Cast iron hates metal utensils. Oh, so no cutting it with a knife. Got ya. So is a metal spatula okay? Wood better. Okay, okay. It's because it chips the seasoning. Oh, it chips the seasoning. Okay, that I understand. Okay, so is this gonna be okay? When cutting the, what do you call it? The cuckoo? Then you're cooking on raw iron. Oh, okay, done deal. I'm gonna stop doing it. Awesome. Love making these videos, man. I learn. I can't believe I've been doing it for so long like this. Craziness. Here, you wanna see what the cuckoo looks like? Thank you for the info, by the way. Take a look. Fantastic, delicious. Okay. Steaming, right? Super good. On the cast iron, honestly, it's probably fine. It's supposed to be flakes to seasoning, but your pan has like the best seasoning ever. Oh, seriously? Thanks, man. I cook with them a lot. As you can tell, I spend a lot of time in the kitchen, man, right? That's good, cuckoo. I like it. We gotta take a look at the rice dish. Let's see what's going on. Okay, I'm gonna turn off this camera. Should we turn off this camera? Let's turn off this camera. Hopefully I'm gonna turn off the right one. Nope. Let's turn off this camera. There we go. Oh, did we turn it off? What's going on? There we go. We turned off this camera. Okay, so let's see where our rice dish is. Let's put this guy, the cuckoo, over here. So it's out of the way. Cuckoo is the sauce, and I'm leaving. I can't handle not having any. I hope you enjoyed the stream, girl joke. It was fun. I've seen cast iron and thrill stoves rusted out. I wonder if they can be... I think they can be rescued, Game of Thrones. Or Game of Thrones. Game at home, mom. Let's check this out. Nice. It's a little bit overdone. I kicked it up a little too high. But you get the idea. This one, not yet. So let's keep that in there. Okay, let's remove this. Okay, so we got the rice. This is like crazy hot, right? We gotta, here, we'll do this guy too. Okay, take a look. Nice, can you see the bottom? Is it done? It could be a little bit more. Let's see. Ah, It's done. It's almost done. So we're gonna try to flip it. Okay. See that? Gonna have to check it. So check this out. Let's do this. Let's make sure we're not gonna, because this is just straight up glass on metal. Hold on. Let's see what the temperature here is like. The temperature is okay. So let's do this. Make ourselves a little bit of space. Man, where's our wooden thing? Oh, it's over there. Let's bring this guy in. Okay. Let's put this guy on the sides. And then we'll put the wood on top. And then we'll put the tray on top of that. Okay. So let's put this guy, oops, here. Let's bring this guy here. Okay, let's flip it. We got a little sauce on there. We don't want the sauce to stick to the bottom, right? Oh, we got a little bit of mush on this too. Oh, that's rice. Okay, good enough. So let's lift this up. We'll do this. Now, when you make this, what you want to do is cut it and flip it, because you don't want the bottom parts to get soft, because when you flip it, it airs out and it gets crunchy, and it should. We'll see. We'll see if it worked out or not. Okay. Let's check it out. Seriously, that cast iron got me messed up. Is that the same one he cooked in order? No, I have two. I have two bigger size. The one I have here, is this the one we cooked in already? Is it? Maybe. Did we cook this one already? No, we haven't cooked in this one already. This is the one we cooked in. Okay, take a look. This is the one we cooked in. Still looks amazing. Right? It's still pretty good. And this just needs just a rinse, right? That's all. Okay. So, and I have the one on the bottom here is a bigger one than the other one, and I have two of those big ones at the bottom of this, right? And I have another little guy that we use and stuff, right? So let's see how this is. Hopefully this is crisped up. I'm doing it over here. You guys might not see it, but I'm right-handed, so. Ooh, look at that. Oh, it hasn't crisped up yet. Lots of juices in the bottom. Take a look. See that? I wanted that to be crispy, right? So we didn't get it crispy. We had a little bit too much juices coming in with the sauce. Take a look. The brownness I saw was basically because of the juices. So this thing requires to be inside a little bit more. Okay. But it is done. The potatoes, like you can see, it squishes, right? Take a look. It breaks apart. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it back and let it get crispy. Okay. We want it crispy. We want it crispy. Let's throw that back. And you don't need the foil on top anymore. Some people, what they do, they keep the foil on top for half the baking in the oven, and then the other half they remove it. Oh, that's the timer going off. I'm going to set the timer another 20 minutes. Okay. They remove the foil, and then the convection sort of gets the rice flowing in a certain way, and the rice sort of puffs up as soon as you remove the foil from the rice and let it cook in the oven for half the time, like another 20 minutes, half an hour, 20 minutes in the oven. The rice puffs up. It has room to flow with the convection, I guess. When I do crispy rice, I put a thin layer of oil on the pan and preheat it before I lay in the rice. Oh, do you see with the rice? It takes one thing with the rice, cruel joke. Rice takes a long time to crisp up, right? The bread crisps up the flatbread fastest. The potatoes second, And then the rice takes the longest time. And for the rice, generally, the way I figured it out, you have to have a higher temperature to crisp up the rice, right? So for me, in general, I put bread. And bread, like 60, 70% of the time, and potatoes the rest of the time. Okay. Think we need liqueur. Let's check it out. Let's do a little bit more liqueur. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna check on the bread one. As long as we can get show you what crispy looks on one of them, okay, we're good to go. I wonder how well it would work if you laid the rice first and potatoes on top. The potatoes wouldn't get crispy. The potatoes have to be in the bottom. You could broil them, I guess. You could put the rice and the potatoes up top, but the problem with that is, same with the bread, the problem with that is when you're cooking it this way, you want the juices to flow down, gravity, right? And the crispy part is not just crispy, dry, it's crispy with amazing flavor, okay? Yeah, because it sucked in all the juices and everything from whatever you're cooking, right? Even the rice adds amazing flavor to it. We'll put an ice cube in there too. Actually, I'm gonna have a sip like this, see if I feel like having a sip like this. For this dish, I might have added a little bit too much juices, so it's curdling in juices, so it's not gonna get crispy, it's just gonna suck in all the flavor of the juices. Okay. Cooking in the kitchen, use ice liqueur on the rocks. Yeah, that's what we want. Right, cool it down. Little bits. Oh, that's looking pretty good. Oh yeah, how's our cranberry doing? Yeah, let's turn this on. So I'm gonna bring out the rice dish, the other one. Okay, let's leave this like this. Let's have a sip of our liqueur. Did you say curdling? Curdling, yeah. At the bottom? I love a made up this curdling, not a real word. I always thought it was a real word. Been using words that don't exist. No way. Who would have thunk it? I think I've been reading too many comic books. Oh, maybe it is. I've never heard it. I don't know. I've never looked it up. Let's see if you can see the bottom. See the bottom? It still needs time. It still needs time. Gurgling is a real word. Do you like the song "Take Me Home"? Take me home. Who sings that? Take me home. Take me home to Paradise City. That's Guns N' Roses, isn't it? That's Guns N' Roses. Take me home to Paradise City with a man. I used to listen to that a long time ago. A long, long time ago. It's the West Virginia song, "Country Road" by John. Oh, "Country Road." Okay, John Denver. That's what it is. Curdling is a better word than gurgling. That's a good song, by the way. It's not in the dictionary. It should be in the dictionary. The dictionary is morph over time, right? So words keep on being added. What I'm going to do is actually grab some of the white rice and eat it with a cranberry, see if it's okay. The white rice. We're getting a little bit of turmeric in there as well. Let's put that on the side. Let's put that over here. We'll put this back in the stove. Let's see. Oh, it's getting a little crispy. That's not bad. It's the top part where the sauces haven't gone in yet. Bit more, just a touch more. Let's put that in there. Cool. Let's try it with the cranberry. Let's check this out. That was the first time us making cranberry come out. Here, let's put the lid here. Texture is good, the consistency is good. Let's put that there. Let's close this guy off. We got 12 minutes. Let's check it out. I love the color of cranberry. Does cooking, comic reviews, philosophy, gaming, mathematics, etc. Just life in general, I guess, cruel joke, right? Life in general. Real life, like things that I love, sharing things that I love in my life. Man, I can't think of a better thing to do, right? Let's see if we added enough sugar. I was trying to find a new streamer to watch. I only found Fortnite streamers of boo streamers. Finally found a nice one. Oh, awesome. Welcome to my stream, brother. Or sister. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Fantastic. That's really good. Mm-hmm. Just would go amazing with the sauce on the side. Let's put a little sauce on the side. So this, the cranberry one, you could substitute with the cherry, right? If for some reason you don't like cherry, and the lemon has given a cranberry nice tangy taste. This cranberry sauce, just what we did right now, for me would be the ideal cranberry sauce with turkey, with chicken and stuff like this. I don't want it to be too fancy. I want it to be tangy, sweet, have the cranberry sharpness. The, I don't know if it's the vitamin C flavor, but it's the cranberry sharpness, right? With this, it'd be fantastic. Let's check it out. Mm-hmm. I think the cranberry just with the rice itself is awesome. I found the frozen cranberries seem to cook about as well as the fresh stuff. I've never cooked the fresh stuff, so when in season, I'll definitely give fresh cranberries a try as well. Just have it with the sauce, rice and the sauce. Mm. What was in the bowl sauce? The the sauce that I put in, the yellow stuff, that was a sauce that we cooked the chicken in. It was turmeric, mint, rosemary, salt, and that was it. And onions, so it's a lot of onions in there. That's the stuff that we first started cooking. Okay.
Fantastic, love it.
Love it, love it. And breads make people look friendly. I don't know why. Beers make people look friendly. Let's bring this out. I'm gonna give this guy a flip. Hopefully we'll get the look of it, but I think I put a little bit too much sauce in there. I know you have a sweet tooth, Chicho. Have you ever made ice cream from banana? No, I've never made ice cream. I've had it though. Family members have made it. Just from bananas, they squish them. And they tasted great. And when it gets crispy, when you pick it up, you should be able to move a fair chunk. It's like cuckoo. Take a look at this. All right, so let's do a flip on this and see what happens. That's what you want. I gotta cut this. It's not gonna do. I don't know if we'll be able to cut it. I need a knife to cut this. Let's put that there. I need a sharp knife. Sharp knife, sharp knife. Let's do. Again, the bread gets crispy faster than the potatoes. So the potatoes are taking a little bit longer. Okay. See that? And you have the chicken stuck to it on this side, right? Stuck on the bread with the onions on top, right? And the sauce is just soaked in. And just imagine with the cherry one, there's a sweetness from the cherry coming down into the mixture as well. And you got crispy here. So I flip it so this stuff doesn't, the bread doesn't get soggy, right? So when you pull this out, when you're serving it, usually in general, you take, scoop off the rice, put it into a tray, right? And then there isn't that much rice left on top. And then what you do, you flip these guys on top of the tray that you're going to be serving. So you have the tray, you have rice piled up, and then you got this crispy stuff sitting on the side or on top, and you just go crazy with it. That's the centerpiece of your food, of your dinner that you're serving people, whatever it might be. Okay, let me move this out of the way and we'll check the potatoes as well. Okay. Let's check out the potatoes. I'm 14 years old and I'm from Germany, the Netherlands. I'm Finn, 14 years old. Hello, Nippy. I hope you're learning how to cook. Every person should learn how to cook. Really, you want to be able to feed yourself, brother. Okay. So let's pull this out. Now, because I have the temperature higher than I usually do, the top has gotten a little bit crispy, okay? We'll take a look at the bottom, see if it's gotten the crispy. I don't think this would have, because I put a little bit too much juice sauces on there. Let's check it out. No, it hasn't got crispy. I can feel it, right? But it's juicy. Here, let me crack this open. Take a look. There's a potato part. I shouldn't have gone crazy with the sauce, but the sauce was so delicious. Less is more for this one, right? See that? The potatoes, they're very squishy, which is okay. It is what it is. You mix all the stuff in, it becomes amazing. We're gonna have to taste this. Like, really. There's absolutely no way we're not tasting this. Alright. Let's check it out. Let's bring out a little pork. Let's do this. Because we want to taste the blueberry with the rice and the chicken. Look at that. That's nice. Let's grab a potato from here. Take a look. Now, halfway through, you could possibly flip it, put the potatoes out, and then put it on broil and have it get crispy that way. Right? Let's check this out. Sorry, I went for... Where are we? Sorry, I went with German. Danish doesn't seem like a real language I could ever comprehend. I heard some European languages are super hard. Super hard. Take a look at this. I don't want to touch them. It's crazy hot. Look at that. Nice. Needs to be on a t-shirt. It is what it is. Maybe we do. Maybe we do. Have you ever eaten schnitzel or yeah, for sure. Or currywurst. Currywurst? Schnitzels for sure. One day we'll make schnitzels. Chicken and lamb schnitzels. So good. Serge, you're aged. Serge is, I think, a year older than me, maybe. Or I could be a year older. He must listen to everything I say. Let's check it out. Nice. I like it. I could have probably added more salt. Bot counter for people making Serge Tankian is the singer for System of a Down. I'm gonna add salt to this. Let's see. And sometimes you do want to add salt to the rice as well. That's a good dish. I like it. Look at this guy. That chicken looks good. A little bit of cherry rice. Nice. I hope you guys have been making food while you're watching this or you've been eating. Favorite System of a Down song, Chicho? I've been asked this. Holy Mountain, I really like, just because of the political significance of it. I loved Hypnotized and Mesmerized. I love the way it was put together. There's a couple of songs there I didn't like, the albums. Okay, I think it was a grand design, but their older albums are brilliant. There's so many songs. Basically everything from their older albums is phenomenal. There's only two songs from the last two albums they put out, Hypnotized and Mesmerized, that I didn't like. The rest of everything I loved. Like BYOB and I don't know the names. I forget the names, right? I just loop. I know the lyrics. There was a period where I knew all the lyrics. Right? Oh yeah. Turn off the timer, we turn off the oven. We're done with that. Turn off the lights. I've always cooked my rice in chicken stock. Have you? Yeah. We've done it before, but usually we, for ours, we use white rice, and then white rice is the base, and then we add stuff to the white rice. I guess chicken stock to the white rice. We do add rice to chicken soup sometimes. Noodles or rice, that's the two main things we add. I order sandwiches because I've been too entranced with this dream. Still, the album was a big part of my youth. Ah, that's cool, man. Amazing, amazing music, System of a Down. Nice. The only other thing I would add to this recipe is I would have added more salt. I forgot to add the salt during the cook when the chicken was cooking, so the salt didn't get absorbed into the chicken when it was cooking. All right, it got absorbed into the sauce because the sauce is liquid, so the salt went everywhere. But I should have added more salt when the chicken was cooking. So keep that in mind if you plan on making this. Okay. I like better than bouillon. For the Europeans, USA is like the big dream. For many Americans, Europe is the big dream with the social safety net that's disappearing slowly, right? Just bought a rice cooker. Should learn how to use it. Use it too cool. Rice is ridiculously easy to cook. Oh, but difficult to cook well, right? Easy to cook to be satisfactory. Difficult to make it phenomenal. Have you ever considered using MSG or Dash when you make curries? I've never used MSG. I wouldn't use MSG. Delicious. I like. I'm like chowing this down. Very good. I'm gonna have a little bit of the bread, crispy bread too. Instructions on the box and you got rice porridge. Yeah, that's what happens. The instructions are crazy. On some of the things I've read, the instructions is like, what? First of all, usually they compensate for the sugar. Most recipes I've seen, they add twice as much sugar as I do. All right? And they cook for longer, they cook for less. If you make rice porridge, Chinese rice soup is fantastic. I've never made it, but I like eating it out. It's really good. Okay, we need to try the crispy bread. I'll show you what this looks like. It's not as crispy as it could be, but it looks pretty damn good. Take a look. Right? It's got the chicken stuck to it and the rice is in the bottom. Okay. I'm gonna try this out. Oh, it's gonna be hot. Hot, hot, hot. Ooh. Mm. Very good, the chicken. This one, I think we might have added salt. I don't know. That was really good. That little chicken bit was fantastic. And dishes with salt pop, like you would believe. Salt pop. I'd love to start using MSG. The hate for it is buried in an oddly racist. Is it? I heard it wasn't really good for you. That looks delicious. That is yummy. I like this recipe. I'm gonna have one more chunk. Very good. Look at that. Mm.
Very good.
Finish it off with a sip of liqueur, and I'm probably gonna sit down and munch a little bit more again. Regarding MSG, it's all lies, really. Probably fed by big salt. It's been widely shown to be completely safe. Really, Casey, I gotta look into that. The MSG hate is back 20 years ago with the food pyramid that suggests eating 5 to 6 servings of carbs a day. Yeah, the carb stuff, the food pyramid was insane. I'll have to look into that. Sounds interesting. Yeah, I gotta look into that too. Didn't know that. Programming, propaganda, right? I'm not immune to it. I get caught up in it as well, which is crazy. Just imagine if we didn't have this programming from the centralized and corporations trying to tell us what to do, what to think, what to eat, what to buy, what to learn, what to listen to, what to watch. Wow, wow, wow. Gang, thank you for being here. I think we just did a 3-hour stream. A 3-hour cooking stream. Yeah, pretty much. 3-hour cooking stream. I hope you guys enjoy it. Thank you very much for the chat. Thank you very much for the info. Some stuff I didn't know. I keep on saying this. I gotta keep on looking back at the chat and looking up some of the stuff that people recommend, especially the food. I forgot some of the stuff Casey recommended. Casey, if you remember, post them on Discord. That way I can, what was that thing? Potatoes, cabbage, and sprouts. I forget what that was called. And then you mentioned something else too that sounded delicious. Saying MSG causes health issues was an attack on Chinese restaurants to some degree and fueled by racism. Very interesting, Roots. I gotta look into that. I linked them on Discord. Yeah, awesome. Awesome, Casey. Awesome. Gang, I hope you have a fantastic Tuesday. If it's still Tuesday where you are. Okay. If not, Wednesday or Monday. I think it's only 24 hours. So it's either Tuesday or Wednesday, my guess is. Okay. And what we'll do, I'll load this video on YouTube and BitChute as well, the cooking streams we are loading on YouTube. And I loaded yesterday's discussion on the great generational transfer of wealth to YouTube as well. So it's available on YouTube and BitChute as well, okay? And then we'll see what we end up doing later on this week. I'm gonna try to shoot some videos if I can get to it. We might do a couple of streams, 1 or 2 streams, maybe Friday, Saturday. I'm not 100% sure. We might play the 10x10 game again. I'll take a look at my to-do list and see where we are. Okay. I will be here next stream, unless I have school. Okay. Thanks for trying to make it, Nippy. Thanks for the great stream, Chicho. I'm on Discord now. I'll see you folks in there. Awesome, Cruel Joke. Awesome. Peace, brother. Peace, man. Peace. Enjoy your day. You guys too. Thanks, Chicho, and everyone for all the good info. And subs. Thank you for the subs. Thank you for the follows. See you next time, Chicho, in chat. Enjoy your day. I got to sleep. It's, you're almost midnight. Nice. Sorry for not being here for the whole. No worries, Spot of Tea. I hope you enjoyed what we got. And I'm going to sit down right now and munch, munch, munch. Okay. Thanks for being here, guys. Gang. And I'll see you guys in the next video or next stream. Bye for now.